EA Sports sponsored League of Ireland Underage Leagues kick off this weekend, so we thought we'd do you a favour, run you through each club in the top two divisions of Irish football and their best youth prospect. It's under 21, so we're taking a few shortcuts here and there, but if you disagree with us, let us know in the comments below. Athlone Town have one of the most underrated youth setups in the country. And although this season Adrian Carberry is plumped for experience, Oisín Duffy has played a dab hand. Ross Tierney has been a shining light for Bohemians this term, and he's been one of the best young players in the league. He capped it all off with a goal at under 21 level for Ireland too. Eyebrows were raised when St Patrick's Athletic let Brian Maher go to Bray Wanderers last term, but Bray don't mind at all. Having been at the club since schoolboy level, it's no surprise to see Vilius Labutis plying his trade in the Cavendish first team. Add to that, he's also a Lithuanian youth international. Oftentimes, Irish footballers find it hard coming home from English academies having not made the grade, but Charlie Lyons, he's been superb since coming home in 2019. Although he hasn't set the world alight since going down to Cork, if you make your debut against Arsenal in the Europa League, chances are you have something about you, and we've no doubt that Jamie Wynn can go all the way. Ronan Boyce is a right back that has a strike rate that is the envy of all League of Ireland strikers, and he's been a shining light for Rory Higgins' youth movement at the Brandywell this year. Although he lost his spot as Drogs number one to Colin McCabe for a few weeks, David Onomosu is back and he's showing an experience beyond his years. Granted, with the attacking talent that Dundalk has, it's hard to see Ryan O'Kane getting into the first team this season, but the 17-year-old is there for the long haul. It's hard to believe that Carlo Sullivan is just 21, particularly in Ollie Horgan's experienced Harp side. He has over 80 first team games already in his career. Galway's Wilson Waweru is an extremely electric and versatile attacker, capable of playing across the front three, and Galway are going to need him if they're going to get promoted this year. Listen, A. Dervin is turning 22 in about a week's time, but he is quite clearly the best player at Longford Town this season. What? Did you think that we weren't going to put in the lad that's been linked to Inter Milan? Zeffy hasn't even made a first team appearance for Shamrock Rovers proper, but he has all the credentials. In an experienced Shell side that's romping home with the first division title, Shane Farrell does all of the midfield jobs necessary to go to the very top of the game. A Leaving Cert student with the legacy of a legendary father hanging over him, Johnny Kenny has been absolutely superb for a Sligo team that's having a renaissance. Don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell notification. Ask any St Patrick's Athletic fan about Darrow Burns and they'll tell you that he's destined for the top. He's an old school winger, can do a trick, but just can go by it with sheer pace. The League of Ireland new boys, Treaty United, have been the story of the season thus far, and their tricky diminutive winger, Edward McCarthy, has played no small role in that. There's something about UCD that just seems to unearth attacking talent. First Georgie Kelly, and now Colin Whelan is certainly following. Although it's been a tumultuous season for Waterford, their young players have stepped up to the plate, and none more so than versatile midfielder Niall O'Keefe. Jimmy Corcoran may be known for that infamous incident against Netherlands for the Ireland under-17s, but he's a talented goalkeeper, and if he plays well at Wexford, who knows where he'll go. And that's the end of the video. Feast on more balls.ie content right here.